Biomass, organic material from plants and trees, is considered a source of renewable energy. But environmentalists are asking the governor to stop funding biomass wood heat in his renewable energy law, stating that this actually hurts the environment. I sat down with Bill Moomaw, a professor emeritus of international environmental policy at Tufts University, and Michaelann Bewsee, who was involved in environmental justice work, to learn more.
The problem from a climate point of view is that the major heat trapping gas in the atmosphere is carbon dioxide. That comes from burning coal, oil, natural gas, and wood. And the carbon dioxide that comes from wood does exactly what the carbon dioxide from burning coal does. And it's assumed that because another tree may grow and absorb the carbon dioxide that was emitted when the wood was burned, that it's carbon neutral. But that's not true. It takes many, many years for trees to regrow, and there's no guarantee that they will regrow. So we're adding carbon dioxide to the atmosphere so rapidly that last October, the world's scientists through the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change said, we have to not only stop putting carbon dioxide in, we have to increase the rate at which it's taking it out. The only thing on the planet that is doing that at scale are our forests. They are removing an amount equal to about a third of what we put in as fossil fuel carbon every year. If we cut them down and burn them, we add carbon dioxide on one side, and we reduce the capacity for decades to a century to take it out. So that's the problem. And that's a new problem for thinking about the role of forests. It has not been on the agenda until recently.
And what steps have you taken, to address your concerns and express them?
I have been engaged with a lot of colleagues on doing the scientific research to get it right, to really quantitatively determine how bad it is. So. One of my colleagues, John Sturman at MIT, produced a paper, two papers last January, or a year ago January, showing that it's worse than coal. The amount of heat trapping you get from burning wood is worse than what if you had burned coal.
And do you think people understand that? Because you
No.
think of biomass, you think, well, gee, that sounds, it is renewable, and
yes, it is.
That sounds like it would be environmentally friendly.
Right, right. No, and it's amazing. Europe is doing this. They are decimating the forests of the southeast U.S. to replace coal with wood, and by legislative fiat are calling it carbon neutral, when the science says it is far from carbon neutral. In fact, it's not only not carbon neutral for the atmosphere, it's not climate neutral in the sense that the climate, we're accelerating the rate of climate change, and that's why it's so urgent that we do everything we can. And the scientific statement that was made last October is that the only thing we have to increase the removal rates is to increase the removal rates by forests, not to cut them down and burn them.
Michaelann, why is this so important to you, and how did you get involved in this issue?
Well, I work with a group called Arise, and we're a low-income rights organization. And when we were invited to a forum at Western New England University on biomass, and it certainly sounded green. That's everything I had heard about it. But after leaving the forum, I had very many concerns, not so many at that time about the renewable aspect, but about burning wood's impact on public health. And we have extraordinarily high asthma rates in the Pioneer Valley and in Hampden County. And 2.5 particulate matter doesn't just affect breathing. It creates all sorts of inflammatory connections, heart disease. So really, we left very concerned. And there was a Springfield project. Actually, there were three biomass plants being proposed in Western Mass all at the same time in Russell, Greenfield, and Springfield. And Russell and Greenfield beat back their plants through community organizing. And our plant, unfortunately, was much further along in the permitting process, but we said, we're going to do this. And we took it on, and 8 years later, the plant still has not been built, although it does seem to be having a life of its own and reemerging as an issue. So we have more work to do to stop the construction of this plant in a community that really can't handle any more air pollution.
And what steps have you taken to let the governor know that this is not something that you would like to see in Massachusetts?
A letter was organized by the Partnership for Public Integrity. 30 major organizations in the Commonwealth signed it, and a significant number of climate scientists signed it. Now, climate scientists aren't really in the business of advocacy, but you know, if I were a cancer researcher and I discovered that the toothpaste we were using was causing esophageal cancer and didn't tell the world about it, I would be derelict in my duty. And I think that's the way a lot of us feel. Here we have and this basically, in fact, that's actually a sad analogy, because a quarter of the particulate matter, this small TM2.5, in the Commonwealth is coming from burning wood. And the Commonwealth is subsidizing this. So we as taxpayers are paying to add more carbon dioxide to the atmosphere, reduce the capacity of our forests to remove it, and adding to the air pollution. And Worcester County, for example, has the highest amount of particulate 2.5 in the country, and Hampden County is also a major, has major concentrations of these pollutants.
What is a less costly zero-emitting alternative, you know, to this?
If it's being used for electricity, solar panels are now the cheapest source of anything. They're cheaper than natural gas. Even some wind projects are cheaper than natural gas. It's certainly comparable to natural gas, and they are both cheaper than burning wood. In fact, the only things that are more expensive than burning wood are nuclear power, which we also have had to subsidize to get it up. And the most, the coal plants that have the largest amount of pollution control on them, that adds a lot of cost. But many of the wood plants are more expensive than coal plants. And so why are we subsidizing these?
And so what's the next step, Michaelann?
Most climate scientists now say we have about a dozen years to make massive reductions in the amount of CO2 we're putting in the atmosphere. So for every dollar that the governor might assume we save on biomass, which actually is not the case, we're going to be increasing the amount of money we spend in public health and changes that we'll need to make to keep weather halfway controllable and the planet halfway livable in the future. And biomass is one of those issues that starts out simple, gets very complicated as you get into the technicalities, but then it gets simple again. What kind of energy do we need in order not to hurt ourselves to produce it? And biomass is not it.